Hey everybody, welcome to eCigTV. I'm here with the Master of Disaster, the Brooklyn Bomber, none other than Dino.
The Bronx. They're not Brooklyn, Bronx.
The Brooklyn Bronx Bomber from Brooklyn. So at any rate, I completely dropped the ball tonight. There's like three people in here and two of them are us. I didn't announce the show. I wasn't going to do one this week, and then I'm going on vacation next week, so I couldn't do one next week, so I did one this week. So, but at any rate, that's one of the reasons. So today was totally nuts. Last night I released the Kick 2. I had a big order from, actually Happy Jack from Canada, has the Can Vapor Can Expo this weekend on Saturday coming up. It's like Canada's first vape meet, and it's supposed to be pretty big. So I sent him a bunch of stuff last week. He sold half of it, so he wanted to get the rest of it, and he wanted to get all his stuff out on Saturday for so he can be exclusive. So I just heard a ding.
Yeah, that was my email.
Awesome. That's a great, I gotta get that. So at any rate, I'm making a long story longer. I was super crazy busy today. I had to go to the dentist. I was supposed to get my final tooth, which I don't know if you can see it. I do not have it. It was the wrong size. My dentist is a perfectionist, and he said, "Nah, I ain't putting that in your mouth." So, I could tell you a whole other story about how I lost it, but I'll pause on that. So, at any rate, this past Sunday, I woke up with fire in my eye about twisting. I got the wire on like Thursday or Friday for the RBAs. So I figure all this stuff, now I'm an expert, man. I've been hanging with Dino, been doing shows about RBAs. I'm an expert now, right? I can build whatever I want. So I wanted to do a show tonight about the real world of RBAs, right? So I wanted, Dino didn't have his thing set up or nothing for the pictures. I was going to set up a camera over here, which I would lift it up, but I got a laptop here. That didn't work out. The last minute, tonight, were my wife and I. My wife told me, if you ever print an international label with FedEx, every time you change a product, you got to reprint the whole thing. I get all stressed out. It takes us an hour and a half to print one label. Now, I print labels all day and all night for 5 years. I mean, I'm an expert label printer. But FedEx don't play well with others. So at the last minute, we get it done. We get the label printed up. She goes in the house to take a shower. I realize I haven't eaten all day. I had 17 cups of coffee and 2 cups of fruit juice. Fresh fruit, good juice, good stuff. But I haven't eaten all day. So my knees are shaking a little bit. They're banging together a little bit. I go in the house. She orders dinner. We order something quick. And she goes in and calls out here and says, who's coming on the show tonight? I go, what show? And I go, inside, on the inside. I said to myself, I didn't say that out loud, of course, because I was alone, there was nobody here. I go, oh my God, I forgot the whole show. Right? So it's 6:57. I haven't eaten. I have nothing set up. And I got to do a show. So I turn on my streaming thing over there. Two of the machines don't start up. One of them is doing an audible beep. So I'm over there trying to, listen, you have to see this. It's like a whole, it's like an animal crawling into a cage. The way I got it set up, I got all these Skype machines. You can't get back air. Bada bing, bada boom. Couldn't fix it. AJ Johnson's here saying, what's up, Dino? I guess that's a buddy of yours. So welcome, AJ.
AJ, yeah. I know AJ.
Good to see you.
Eight ball AJ. He's a pool player.
Really? Does he have a Meucci Q? Do you have a Meucci Q?
Does anybody have a Meucci?
A Meucci Q. I have one that matches the pool stick. You know, Bob Meucci was the world champion Hall of Fame pool player. I got two of them, but I have matching sticks too. But when he reneged on making the things, he owed me like 12 more of them, and he sent me pool sticks instead. I had them on my site for a while. For real, I told him, look, you know, he was going to give me a refund on American Express. I said, send me some of the sticks. Give me a wholesale deal on the sticks. I'll get rid of them sooner or later, you know. So I got about three or four of them. They're great sticks from what I understand. So anyway, back to the bullshit. I mean, back to the original story. I'm out here. I got no food. I turn on the system. It don't work. I run in the house, jam three slices of pizza down my throat. Come back out here. We got it working to some semblance of order, but I have no camera. I know whatever. So, back to the other beginning of the story. This weekend, I wake up and I decide I'm going to make a sub-ohm RBA. I got the best stuff, right? I got the cable. One size, I got the 1 millimeter cable, or 1.5 millimeter cable. I got the 3 millimeter cable. I got the Temco A1 Canthal annealed 0.05 by 1 millimeter ribbon wire. That's about $600 worth of stuff right here. Here's another $600. I got a roll of the Canthal A1 annealed flat resistance 0.8, 1 ohm. So, no, listen, I'm an atomizer guy, right? I'm going to build me up a couple of these things. I know everything there is to know about atomizers. I've been hanging with Dino for a few weeks. He's been giving me tutelage, his tutelage, and I'm going to make a perfect atomizer. Better than anybody ever made in the history of America, right? I get out my torch. I get out my... I got these from a place. I found them. These are pretty cheap. If you remember a couple weeks ago, Dino was showing off them real expensive pliers. He had $50. I got these for $14. I got 20 of them, right? I got 20 of these, right? Just in case I need them. 20 packs of these, right? Plier sets. Whoops, almost dropped one out of there. 20 sets of pliers with spring grippers, right? You grab them, they open back up by themselves, huh?
Fancy.
I got a pencil. I got 20 pencil torches. I got everything, right? I got it all out here on the table. Sunday morning, I got a nice, delicious hot cup of coffee. I'm going to twist this thing up. No problems. I get out. I cut a piece of the cable. The cable cutters cut it perfectly. Don't crush it or nothing. Now, on my big screen across the room, I got the thing of Dino playing the tutorial 1 week on the top screen, and the next week on the other screen. So every now and then, I'm jumping up and running over there and fast forward, pausing. I'm getting everything right. I get the cable out, cut a piece of the cable, get a piece of my mesh, right? Cut a piece, you know, I measure it just like he does it on a thing. I get it on there, I twist the cable around it. I got the things perfect. Perfect, right? I have my Opus D out here. I'm doing it right on the Opus D. It's acting as a holder, right? So I test it, it's right. I forgot to burn it, right? So I take it back out, no problem. I take it out, I got all the proper tools to do it. I take it back out, I grab it with my spring-loaded pliers, right? I grab it, I heat it up. I don't have the big torch, but I'm using the little torch. So I heat it all up. I loosen up for a second, it drops. I pick it back up, heat it back up. No problem, right? So I said, this is nice and hot. I'm going to set it down and let it cool. I set it down and let it cool. I don't know if you can see that. It burns directly through all the way down onto my nice wooden table, melts this priority mailing envelope right through it. Can you see it? Here I am. Wait. See that hole? Yoo-hoo. Burnt right through, right down onto my table. Destroyed a wick that I had. I had the thing all hung up. Now it's got molten plastic all over it. Take it back out, get another piece, cut it, wind another one, get it on the unit, start heating it up. Now, for some reason, when it's hot and when I first put it on there, it's reading 0.08. I get it all put back together and it's reading 0.12. Or no, 1.2. So I rewrap it. Make a long story short, or a long story longer, I should say. I used around 20 feet of this $18 a foot cable, and I still have an atomizer that is running at like 4.5 until I hold the button down. Then it's running at 0.8. If I hold it down on the Opus D, only if I do it on the Opus D. Now, I have the kick 2 that day too. I forgot to tell you that. I have my sample kick 2. Goes to 15 watts. Woohoo, right? Well, for some reason, I can't get no vapor out of this thing. I messed around with it for probably about, I'm going to give everybody a little leeway, I'm going to say 4 hours, right? Could not get the thing down. Now, this is what I figured out. But unfortunately, I was doing this on Sunday, and I figured it out on Tuesday, that the wire, you don't, now Ohm's law, the more wire, the less resistance, right? The bigger the wire, the less resistance.
The bigger the wire, less resistance.
Yes. The bigger the wire, the less resistance. Well, what I was doing, like a genius, was adding more wire. So I'm adding more turns. So on this little puppy right here, I have 9 wraps of 0.08 canthal wire and can't figure out why I can't get it down to sub-ohm.
You know what's on here?
God, tell me.
3 reps of 0.8 a candle.
Wait, you're blowing big clouds? God, show us that big cloud you blow. He did this to me earlier today. He took like a 3-second hit and blacked his camera out with it. Right? With an 18350 battery. Now, I got a 26650 battery, or a 26500 battery, IMR, with a kick 15, a kick 2 on air, and I can't get a wisp of vapor out of it, right? I was so pissed off. I was terrible. Yeah, it was terrible. So right now, I was going to do this on camera. I might even do it. I'm not going to do it on camera. I might not do it at all. Oh, here we go. I'm going to take this. All right, hold on. I'm going to take my speakers. I'm going to take my listening device off for a second. I'm going to grab my Opus D so I can test this. Hold on just a minute. I got this puppy all charged up. Nice fresh charge. Pulling right off the charger right now. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take about 16 wraps off of this bad boy.
You're gonna do this now?
I'm gonna do it right now. Yeah. Right. You wanna talk
to me? We're not gonna be able to watch you?
I don't have the camera, dude. I can't. But you get a good laugh out of it. But
could,
but you know,
it'd
listen,
be more
the,
funny
the,
if I could watch
do you wanna sit here?
No, no. The moral of this story is, you know, I was gonna name the show RBA's The Real World. Because you watch, like, I'm sure there's guys in here that do the same thing. There's Martha P. West. She says, hi, don't seem to be connected right. Press play, Martha. I think Martha's that... Is that genius coil wrapper lady? I think I might have read one of her posts somewhere. Maybe not. I might be confused. So I was going to name this show RBA's The Real World. Because when you watch all these guys do these in their little videos, like Dino and all the other guys that do these, well, I guess, you know, I don't know if Dino does tutorial videos.
I did a few.
But when you watch them, they make it look real easy. When you go to do it, it ain't so easy. So yeah, I'm pushing this in here. I got a spring-loaded top wire here. I got one, two, three. Got it in there. My scissors. So I already had this wound, you know. I know I look really smart. Now I got four in there. I'm going to test it. Wait, let me just.
You got four wraps in there now? Is it round cantle or is it flat cantle?
Flat.
It's flat? All right. Don't hit it hard. Hit pulse it.
No, well, it's not new. This is all burnt. I use this for, you know, this is the one I've been. Still not really glowing.
Take another wrap off.
TV.
Take another wrap off.
Okay, hold on. I'm gonna let everything cool down here. I learned my lesson the other day. Dan Patrick, my man. So look, everybody wants to see you wind coils now, Dion.
No, they came to see you wind the coil. They
I didn't wind the coil. I didn't properly
I'll show you
spam
something
or
nice. I'll show you a nicely wound coil.
Okay, hold on a second. Let me take one more wrap out of this.
Yeah, take a look at that. Can you see that?
Put them full screen, mama.
Is that focused?
Hold on. Wow. I can see that.
See the cable in the bottom?
Yeah, see, now you're showing off, dude. Yeah, that's
why not?
You didn't need to show that to embarrass me. Could embarrass me a lot easier than that. All right, I think I got this. Hold on. Hold the phone, Joan. Now I think I got... Oh, this is what a mess this is now, man. I don't think you're supposed to rewind these things.
Yeah, while you're trying to figure that out, I got this new Addy tank in today.
We're glowing out.
Are they glowing evenly?
No, but it will be in a second. I'm going to run over and get some tweezers. Oh, no, here you go. Look at this. I got a little toolkit here. I look like a professional. All right, what are you going to show us? Show us.
I got this in the mail today. And I've been waiting for this for a long time. This is a Vela Latina, they call this. A Vela Latina. And it's an Addy tank, and it takes a 306 Addy.
Really?
This is probably one of the most sought-after Addy tanks in existence right now.
In the history of man?
I hate it.
Really?
Oh my God, I hate it.
How much you pay for it?
A lot. a lot. It's not, I don't know. I got it. Again, it's, I just got it. So far, I'm having a lot of trouble with it. I cannot get this thing to work right. I gotta call up some people and get a little, some pointers. And I don't know, man. I don't know. This is like the hottest thing out. Everybody's looking to grab it.
How much was it?
I think the whole thing was with, you know, all the extra tips, all the extra tips and stuff was like $350. Something around there. Yeah. Wow. I was right. And then I got this other little thing. This is called a K-Fun Light. I think I showed you this already. This thing was like $120. This thing is like the best thing since sliced bread.
That's sexy.
Oh, it works like unbelievable. I mean, I've been using this all day on a 18350 battery, and it just kicks ass. Really does.
Yeah, that's what you were vaping on when we were talking earlier, right?
I actually put cotton wick in this thing. And
show me that.
It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. I like it so much better than the silica. But, yeah, they want lava gems? Here's lava gem right here. Yeah, I'll show you something else. Yeah, this is pretty cool.
Yeah, that's
it's my first dual coil built. Hang on a second. Let's see here. Is that focused?
Yeah, that's the one you were showing me earlier. That's pretty sexy too, dude.
This came out to
a dual micro coils, right?
Dual micro coils. Yeah, it came out to it's 26 gauge cantball, and it meted out to 0.4 ohms. And this thing. This is friggin' insane. Can you hear that?
Yeah, I can. Sounds like you're frying eggs. Sounds like there's an egg in a pan. That's what it sounded like through my speaker. It sounded like
yeah.
you cracked a fresh egg in there. So listen, I think I'm going to rewrap a wire on this. Because I got it three wraps, but one of the wraps is stuck all the way down underneath it. The mesh that I have wrapped around a cable, and it's sort of stuck. And
no, you got to get that out.
Tightening it up. Yeah, I had like 9 coils on there, so I was like stretching it, tightening it up. But I'll tell you what, watch this. That's a pretty good hit. Not as good as yours.
Well, you don't want them too tight.
It's 0.8 ohm.
You measured
it? Listen, you want them tight when you're wrapping 9 winds around them, because that's what I was doing, because last week you said 9 turns, like 14 times. So I'm thinking to myself, I got to get 9 winds in this sucker.
Yeah,
try getting 9 winds of flat wire.
That was 26 gauge cantball.
I know that now.
Oh.
I didn't know that Sunday morning.
Right.
It's Tuesday, Dino.
Right, okay.
It's Tuesday. Remember you told me yesterday or this morning or whatever, we figured out the big mess, the confliction. But it's working all right. But I'll tell you what, now I got the recipe. I'm going to put 3 wraps. Maybe I'll do it right now. Like, what else do I got going on?
A lot of people came here to watch you wrap a coin, so.
All right, I'm going to do it. There we go. Get this. So I'm going to use the 0.8, right?
I would use 0.8. If you want to go low resistance, go to 0.8 and do 0.8, a 3 wrap.
A1, Cantal, annealed.
You know, I just actually bought pre-annealed wire. I don't know if anybody's used this yet.
That's what this is.
Well, I never even knew they made pre-annealed wire. And you know, usually you get the 26 gauge or the 28 gauge. You got to torch it so that it, you know, gets the memory out of it. This pre-annealed stuff is, it's already done. It works great. It works really good.
Yeah, it really does. I use 20 feet of it to make a bad coil. It's working excellent.
Where's this camera?
Right there.
Do you want me to point it down?
No. There it is. Is that too long? You got about 5 inches there.
Well, you want enough to work with.
Yeah, I got money to burn. Listen, I'm burning money. Okay, so this one I'm going to do. I'm going to lock this so I don't push the button while I'm doing it. I'm going to take this right out, right here on live eCigTV, right before your eyes. I'm going to show you how to bumble one of these up real quick. Dude, are you reading the chat? This guy, no, Dan Patrick, he's got a million of them. A minute ago, he was telling me he thought he was on the what was it? The Johnny Winter show or something.
A Nelson concert.
Oh, a Nelson concert. Now he's saying you look like a disembodied corpse. He said, you need a black screen too. You look like a disembodied corpse floating over me. What? Oh, wait. Oh, look, he's giggling. Yeah, I can make him laugh. Fine. Oh. All right, so I'm pulling this out of here. Here it is. Whoa, there it was. Dropped it. So if you just want to refer back to Dino's video, oh, that's the other thing I told you. I forgot to tell you. When I first made this, Dino gave us instructions on how to unwind it and pull that piece of nylon out of the center. I didn't do that. I smoked it instead. It was better. So, I'm going to take this off. I decided I'd smoke it. Oh, here we go.
How'd that nylon taste?
You know what? It tastes a little funny, but it wasn't bad. It wasn't as bad as it's cracked up to be. I may have to get another piece of... Yeah, how
would it? While you're doing that, anybody want to buy a Vela Latina?
How much?
No.
All right, so here I go. I got 325 food grade. You know, they make you some food grade now. Email. All right, so I'm going to take this and I'm going to cut a sliver of it. This I only used around 50 yards of, because I got pretty good at it. This stuff I've actually used before. I've made wicks before. I just never made a ribbon one with a cable where you got to do all this stuff. So I'm gonna do about, what do you think, three winds around it?
Yeah, three wrap.
No, I'm saying for the mesh. Does it matter?
What do you mean for the mesh?
The mesh around the cable.
No, just enough. Two is fine. You just want to cover the get a flat surface for it to lay on.
Fries are done. Okay, so I saw you rolling it. I'm going to roll it like that, my fingers. I saw you do that on the video. I only watched that 14 times. Now, I'm going to get my... my other pliers. The never mind. Take that back. Now, keep in mind, don't take this one to the bank, because I already cooked this about 40 times. I'm just going to re-cook... the mesh. Get it nice and red hot, just like the video. It's on fire. It's got some liquid in it. Now, I was reading another tutorial somewhere where he said, when you're doing this, you can... dip it in your favorite e-liquid, and it pre-primes it. Now, I asked the master of disaster over there, the Bronx bomber, and he said he never did it, but it probably wouldn't hurt. So when I originally did this, I was doing that. I was actually just pouring a couple drops on there to help cool it off quicker. But this time, I got my sheet to set this down on. Why, you say? So it doesn't burn through the priority mail envelope. That's why. Okay, I'm letting it cool. I don't hate waiting for stuff. I just want to grab it.
Grab it.
No, I ain't grabbing it. I don't want to grab it that bad.
That'd be good content.
Yeah, right? No, it's still hot. Pour a cup of coffee on it. So what else is new, brother? What's new and exciting in your world?
I just booked my hotel for Virginia.
Oh, that's what I forgot to do.
And I did that this morning. I paid for my table.
And well, I did that a couple, 2-3 weeks ago. But I told that number out for the thing. I got the email today, and it was so nuts that I didn't get to it.
And I made sure that Lou was putting you, me, and Cisco next to each other.
Yeah, he's good like that.
So we should have a pretty good time down there. And hopefully, I will have a new Genesis to debut there.
Any word on those the Greek thing?
Yeah, we might be getting our money back.
Really?
Yeah.
What happened? You went off on him?
No, the guy is, he's not holding up to his end of the bargain. If anybody wants to know, we ordered this DNA 20 tube mod from a modder on Vaporwall, and he's having a lot of trouble. He's been saying for 2 weeks that it's going to get sent out, and doesn't look like it's coming. So if nothing changes by tomorrow, we're going to get our money back. So
did he ship to anybody?
Nobody.
Oh, see, I thought you said we were on a list and... Tell you what, I know, not because I'm smart, but because I've done a couple mods here and there. What did I do? Made that too long. It's tough, man. You, there I am. Yeah, that's hilarious.
See what the hell is that? What is that?
My wife's in cahoots with Dan Patrick. Honey, you know who Dan Patrick is? Dan Patrick is the guy that makes the commercials.
The guy that makes the commercials?
Oh, God damn it. Yeah, the guy that makes the inhaler commercial.
And the women love it?
Yeah, the women love it. I told him you didn't love it, but he fixed it. Now, one thing about this flat wire, it could be a bit of a pain in the ass to flatten out under the screws, under the one screw. But once you do that, it stays under there a lot better than the other wire, I think. So I got that under there, I think.
If this is going to take 4 hours...
See, now you're going to start making fun of me? That's not going
to
help. Oh,
I may have to go use the bathroom. I'm just letting you know.
Hey, listen, pal, you know, whatever. You got to go. I don't want you having any accidents on TV.
You'll never know it.
Okay. I think we got the ignition on the bottom screw, on the bottom wire. That looks good. I'll pull this up. Actually, I have two wraps there. So I'm going to make one more. I think it's easier to take one off than it is to put another one on. If I'm boring, I can't talk and do stuff at the same time.
I want to jump in there and help you.
I wish you would. Oh, I just pulled it out from underneath the other one. Damn it. See, you know, this is what I'm talking about. You watch Dino, he's got that fancy holder, he's got all the right tools, he's got little electric screwdrivers, nippers, but us regular people, he ain't got all that. So makes it, when he does it, he makes it look like, you know, it's nothing. Done in 5 minutes, right? I'm twisting, I'm turning, I'm tightening, I'm loosening, just lost it again.
Yeah, I'll show you what it's supposed to look like. This is a 3-2 wrap of 0.8 Canthal.
What's that mean?
It's 3 on one side, 2 on the other, but it's a 3 wrap. There's the replay for my wire.
Yeah. Look how easy he makes it look. I can't get this. Okay.
No good, huh?
Be a 2-2, but I get it. There. Man, what a mess. Straighten this up a little bit. You see, I gotta take this thing off here again. Probably not a good idea. Let me just test them. Yeah, that's too low.
What is it?
It won't even read it. It's saying check atomizer.
No, that doesn't mean it's not reading it. It means it's just not making contact or something like that with the DNA twine.
a tire. See, that's why you go through 20 feet of wire. Another one of them. Gotta get this nice and tight on here. Okay. Yeah, I think you're right, Dan. I think you're absolutely right.
What'd he say?
No, he says in there, he said he likes the idea of this flat wire, but it's really easier. It's easier with the 28 canto. And he's right, because it's nice and, you know, this is a little bit
tricky. I tell you the truth, I actually like the canto, the flat canto a lot. If you can get it, what you got to do is, Drew, you got to lay it flat underneath the screw.
Right.
Tighten it down, and then what you do is you grab the wire and you kind of pull it and twist it vertically so that you can wrap it around the coil.
That's what I'm going to do right now. Listen, believe it or not, I have one of these, a really nice one, when I was sitting here by myself, nice and quiet. But I kept messing with it because I couldn't get the right... the right ohms. You know what I mean? So I kept the first one look beautiful. So I'm going to do, exactly what you said. I'm going to twist this so it goes under the screw nice. Got that one flat. And I got this one flat. Let's start with that one. But you know what it is, when you get this on there, you don't get it in the socket the first time, the first couple times, I should say. It, the coil loosens up. And once you start playing around with that, it's hard to tighten it back up without messing all this up. Did what I just said. I actually did it. I was describing it. Fucked the thing up. I was talking about what not to do. I did it.
Skype
want to
know if they can purchase that thing Dino's using.
Yeah, they can.
What thing?
The holder thing.
Yeah, that...
Got it from, like, Asia.
No, I got it from Greece.
Yeah, same thing.
Part
of Asia,
yeah. Where the hell did I buy it? M&M Vapors.
That's my next move, is making one out. You know who else, too? I got to tell you, I saw it somewhere, and I haven't had the time to really go into a site and order it. But you know the guy, Mark, from Mark's Pens and Mods? He makes a wooden one.
Yeah, that would work too.
Yeah, it's got like, it's like a wooden one with a pressed in, you know, just a standard pressed in 5-10 connector in there. Mm-hmm. But it was nice looking. Like I said, I'd probably have one now if I had more hours in my day.
Dan wanted to know about pulling the wrap at the top. You do the same thing when you get to the top of the coil. Kind of put your thumb on the coil where the ribbon is going to make connection with the, and just kind of turn it horizontally so that it goes flat into the connector. I don't know if that made any sense, but you got to kind of make it. It's going to be laying flat against the wick and when you're making your coil. When you get to the top, all you want to do is just pull it and turn it so it lays flat, and then you can capture it in the connector. How you doing over there?
Any second now, pal. Got it. This thing twisted itself back. I'll twist it again. A little more parallel. Push down on these thingamajiggies. Try and slide it right in, but it ain't working, so slippery. Snugging up. Uh-oh. Okay, got it. This will snug up. Might be too low.
What do you mean? Why is it? Take it off the DNA 20. Put it on a mechanical mod.
I am. That's what I'm doing right now.
And don't hit it hard. Hit it light. Pulse it. Because if you hold it down, you'll blow the coil if it's got a hot spot. Pulse it.
I did.
I'm saying don't hold it down. Is it glowing evenly?
No.
What's hot? Top, bottom?
Top and the bottom.
Top and the bottom are hot?
Yep.
So grab something pointy and just kind of push the coils around a little bit while you're firing it. And you'll see it. You move it one direction, things might, you know, start to even up a little bit.
He was right. All right, hold on. So I'm going to snip this now. I didn't trim it yet.
What are you trimming?
The excess.
The wire?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. You need bigger scissors.
No, I don't.
I'm being sarcastic.
Yes, you are. Oh, man. Knock the bottom off.
Knock the bottom of what off?
Knocked it out from underneath the screw, trimming it.
How the hell did you do that?
Dude, I'm telling you, I'm half an ape here. I got hands like, what do you think, I'm a ballerina? I got man hands. Push that back under there.
Not to put any pressure on you, but we're running out of time.
You son of a bitch!
Do you want to give something away or something?
Yeah, what do you want to do?
Do something.
You better do something.
Yeah, better. She said it like that too, didn't she? You better do something.
Yeah.
All right, listen. We're gonna give away a kick too.
Ooh, very nice.
All right, we got a nice crowd in here.
To all the viewers, I promise this will not happen again.
You're a dirty... You just put me right under the bus, didn't you?
This is not... I will not let you do this again. I will not put these people through the pain of watching you wrap a coil. I will do it myself. I love your wife is in the background giggling.
Alright, now you see, now I fixed it. Man, it was all glowing perfect.
Now just like I said, take the tweet or whatever you use to tweak the coil while you're burning it, and it should, all those coils should light up evenly. What are you cutting now?
You're going to start your laptop.
Oh no, I got it. What?
You're going to start your laptop on fire.
Oh, I got it. Oh! I'm going to put the cap on here. I'm going to attempt to extinguish the flasher.
Can we see it?
No, because it looks like a penis. This is a prototype cap. This is the one that I'm making.
No, I want to see the coil lit.
Right, hold on.
I can't see nothing.
I'm going to test it. I want to make sure. Oh, hey, whoa.
You
saw that smoke, didn't you? All right, wait. I'm going to pull my things off. You're not going to be able to hear me, and I can't hear you. Can you hear them, hon?
While he can't hear us, anybody in the chat that thought this was painful to watch him wrap a coil, just say yes. I'm really curious this because I know it was painful for me. And I know he can't hear us right now. So now's the time to really, you know, unless he watches the replay, he'll never know. I know his wife is not going to give me up. Yeah, see? Everybody agrees with me.
What's he saying?
Not for nothing. He did a pretty good job on it. Not bad. Oh, ah. Got a hot spot.
Now it's still.
Tell him to tilt it.
Still not. Tilt it.
Huh?
Tilt it.
Tilt it?
Yeah. Tilt it so the wick is out of the juice.
So the wick is out of the juice.
So we can see it burn.
So you can see it burn. It looks like you have dust particles coming out of your nose. That's crazy.
There you go, like that.
I do.
There you go, like that, he said.
Yeah, he looks like he's got it pretty good.
Huh?
So it's burning a little hot on the top. Oh.
This is the, this is the penis cap. Listen, the guys who are do all my work, get back on here. The guys have been doing my work for years. You know, they made the first exhaler for me. Great machine shop. Good guys, man. Regular guys. They do a lot of work for the military, but it's a family. The whole shop, they're a family. So they always mess with me. You know, they ever since the first day I walked in there, they've been telling me, like, you know, these things look like dildos and all this stuff you're making and all that. So they made like a handful of top caps, and I told them I wanted to mess around with the air. So make some, drill one, and then hold the other ones off. So they made this one. They're internally, they're all the same, but they showed me like some of the different things. The one I ended up with is actually going to match the same contour as the bottom of the regular size curve, so it'll look like it's one piece, like they were made together. I better unlock that button now. I can unlock it. All right, so I'm going to take a couple more and wipe this up. Oh, look at you. I don't have all the juice in here. I could.
Want to see what I did while you were? Want to see what I did while you were testing it?
No. I like that. Yeah, all right, go ahead. Show off.
Hold on. Hold on.
You're full screen. Yeah, but you're above the 0.9. I see. Just trying to make me look dumb. And it ain't that hard in this particular end. Wow, I got that up too high. I had it at 20 watts. So it's 0.9, 3.9 volts. I got to put more juice in there.
So you got 0.9 on 3 rep. That's about right with a point with 0.8 ohm wire. 0.8 wide wire, I should say.
Yeah, that's pretty good. I'm going to show you what I was doing the other day. This was fun. What?
What are you doing?
Oh my God. Listen.
Torched it a little bit. And then I was pushing the button. I pushed it by accident. I saw that in a movie somewhere. I'll tell you what, I think I could open a safe with this thing if I had to. All right, so to kick two, Dino, help me out here. Make something up.
Make something up?
Mm-hmm. Ask a question or something.
God, I hate when you do this.
Listen, we're old, all right? So don't get too fancy. It's got to be something like I can remember the answer or something. Don't trick me. You got to trick them.
All right. You know what? How many people are in the chat?
12.
12 people? All right. I'm going to go to random.org. Random.org. All right. I'm going to pick a number between 1 and 20. Everybody gets one guess.
Can I guess?
When I say go, everybody pick one number. If two people pick the same number, the first person is going to win the prize.
They're already picking numbers.
Okay, so when I tell you start, you start.
They already started.
It's all right. They could start again. It's no big deal. Let me pick the number first. Hold on 1 second. All right. I'm going to put the number in the Skype so you know what it is.
All right, but listen, there's a delay, so.
All right, so then we got time.
Well, he can't do that because the Skype thing comes up so that everybody sees it. They just all saw it. I guess 14.
Yeah, how does it come up in the Skype?
Because you're.
Because we got you full screen.
Oh, is that right? All right, I'll do it again. Hold on a second. I won't put it in the Skype.
Everybody guessed 14. Listen, don't tell us what it is, all right? Keep us in suspense.
I didn't know that would happen. All right, remember, 1 to 20, go.
It starts at A.J. Johnson's the first number in.
Okay.
3, 5, 19. We got a double.
Pat, pick another number. Keep Dan going. Patrick, another
Nobody
number.
Nobody guessed it yet.
11.
Dan Patrick needs to
15,
number.
9. 7. Low point.
Nobody's getting it.
1. 12.
3. 10. 2.
6. 10.
19. 4. 14. 11. 2. 2.
All right, William Vapor got it.
20.
14?
20.
No, it was 20. William Vapor got
20.
It.
All right, William Vapor, congratulations. Listen, I want to thank everybody for stopping in tonight.
You.
We had fun. I hope yous had fun. Yous. And I hate going overtime. Check us out next week, or 2 weeks will be. Dino's going to do a real rebuttal. He's going to do what I just did, but he's not going to mangle it.
The next time
he will have this.
The next time we come in, I'll rebuild this. I just got this in. It's called a doodlebug.
Doodlebug.
So I'll build this from scratch.
Cool. Well, by then you're gonna have one of these without the penis cap, hopefully. So maybe you do two.
All right, no
problem. Show us how to do this, and I'll do a live interactive tutorial where I'll have my setup all fixed up, and we'll do it live, and we'll have some fun with it. All right, listen, again, thanks, everybody. Thanks, Dino. Thanks, Ange, my wife, who makes this all possible by allowing me outside after 8 o'clock and running the switchboard and doing all the live streaming and all that stuff. It's been a lot of fun. Thanks very much. Have a great week.
Good night.
eCigTV, signing out.